One of the more popular options for fastening an LED to a heatsink is our pre-cut thermally conductive Bergquist Bond-Ply 100 tape. Now, this fastening method offers a fast and simple way to create a highly efficient thermal bond between the LED assembly and the heatsink without the need for messy adhesives, grease, or any mechanical fasteners. Currently, we offer a variety of pre-cut patterns to match all of the LED assemblies that we have available, including tape for the 20mm stars. We also have tape for 10mm squares, the 20mm tri-stars, and the 23mm quad LED assemblies, and of course our 40mm 7 LED assemblies. Now we also have tape for the less popular assembly configurations as well. So here I'm going to demonstrate how to use double-sided thermal tape to fasten a 20mm star LED to a heatsink over the exact same process as used for all the LEDs that we offer. Now, using double-sided thermal tape really is pretty easy. However, there are a couple of very important steps that you need to follow to ensure that you create a high-quality thermal bond between the LED assembly and the top of the heatsink. First, you need to make sure that both surfaces are impeccably clean. The best way to do that is with isopropyl alcohol and a clean wipe. So I'm just going to clean off the top of the heatsink here. And you do the same thing for the back of the LED. Make sure that there's no greases or oils and that the surface is nice and dry as well. Okay. Now once cleaned, you're ready to peel off a thermal pad from the plastic backing. Best way to do that is with a pair of tweezers. Like so. And then you position the pad onto your heatsink. And just press it down with your thumb. And then we want to remove the paper backing from the thermal pad. Just like so. And then take your LED assembly. Make sure it's nice and dry. Okay. And we'll just drop that right on top of the tape. And just carefully press it down with your fingers without touching the LED. Okay. To ensure a thermally efficient bond, it is very important that you apply at least 10 pounds or more of pressure on top of the LED assembly. The more pressure you can apply, the more efficient the bond will be, as shown in this graph. Here we can see that with about 10 pounds of initial interface pressure, we will get a thermal performance of about 4.4 degrees C per watt. While if we apply about 100 pounds of initial pressure, this will improve to about 3.2 degrees C per watt. Now this pressure only needs to be applied for about 30 seconds when you first assemble the LED to the heatsink. Now in order to apply as much pressure as evenly as possible across the surface of the LED, we now include these handy little LED presses with each order of thermal tape. There's an LED press for each type of LED assembly that we offer. For example, this press will work with any single LED assembly, like this star. This one here will work for our tri-star LED assemblies. You can see there's openings for the LEDs to accommodate the LEDs on the press. And we have one for our quad LED assembly. Again, there's openings for the LEDs to fit in, so you can push down without touching or hurting the LEDs. And then, of course, we have a press also for our 7 LED 40mm round assemblies. Now, to use the press, you simply position it over the LED assembly with the LED in the opening, and then apply 10 pounds of pressure or more for at least 30 seconds. Now there's a number of ways you could do this. You could simply use your hand and push down for 30 seconds. You could put a weight on top, or you could use a clamp like what I'm using here. And you just clamp it and let it sit for 30 seconds. No matter how you do it, it's extremely important that you apply this pressure for 30 seconds or more to ensure a sound bond. So after 30 seconds, you can remove the press, and the LED is ready to be used. Now, as the LED is used, the performance of the thermal tape is actually going to improve.